My name is Lauren Wallner, and we're here at the University of Michigan in the Department of Medicine. I'm a faculty member in the CanSORT group, which is a cancer surveillance outcomes and research focused group of investigators. Well, I grew up in New Jersey and also here in Michigan. I was a pretty curious kid by nature, and I think my parents really supported that and were always giving us opportunities to learn about new things and travel and really foster that. I was always really sort of interested in medicine and health in general, and particularly had a fascination with diseases and why they happen and what happens once you get them. So I decided to go to University of Michigan for my undergraduate training, and I was pre-med initially, and I thought that I wanted to be a physician. And it was really during this time that I was exposed to the discipline of public health and the idea that you could improve health on a population level and actually affect more people than you would by being a physician, potentially. So I then went on to get a PhD in epidemiology. You know, my work really blends both epidemiology and public health with medicine. So the majority of my research focuses on trying to improve care for both breast and prostate cancer patients. And so what I try to do is build the science to understand patients' care and support needs while they're going through treatment and after in the survivorship period. I design and analyze and run research studies of patients with cancer. Okay, so one of the studies that we have going in the field right now is a large survey study of women with breast cancer. So we're currently sending survey packets to over 5,000 women and asking them a variety of questions about sort of their treatment experience, how they made their decisions for treatment for breast cancer, a lot of questions about the care that they're receiving, and so on. So in order to sort of disseminate our information from our research findings, what we normally do is we publish in medical journals. We present at meetings that are with other clinicians and oncologists who treat cancer patients.
Into a system where it could populate information that would be added to a sort of personalized or tailored survivorship care plan.
One new avenue actually that we're using quite a bit now is social media. So most of the faculty in our group have an active presence on Twitter. We're engaging with patients that way as well. We also are developing some pretty cool tools where clinicians can access information online to get what they need to help better care for their patients. And we're doing the same for patients. So we develop web-based tools where patients can get information to help them make better cancer treatment decisions or understand what they need to do after treatment to keep up with their care needs. So the cancer group in general is a very dynamic bunch of investigators. We are all very, very passionate about what we do.
I think genetic testing tool, we gotta develop that.
We all come from different backgrounds, so I'm actually the only epidemiologist on the team, and with that I bring the training that comes along with that, and so, you know, we have weekly team science meetings where we get together in a room and we talk about the science, and we talk about, you know, designing the science, carrying out the science, the details of it, but really, you know, it's an avenue to bring together ideas from people of various backgrounds and try to improve upon those ideas. We definitely have a regular interaction where we try to sort of problem solve things and come up with solutions for what we're facing, as well as, you know, really trying to, again, generate those unique ideas and those unique research questions that will, you know, ultimately make a difference in cancer patients' lives.